Well, happy Friday. It is Friday before Memorial Day. So I'm kind of kicking off my weekend early. Today is T-7. And I think I've only had like one real meeting. I had one meeting canceled for next week. And then I have one meeting that I was asked to join because everybody wanted to wish me happy retirement and see me off. A lot of community, again, this community I've created inside the company has helped out quite a few people. So it's interesting because when you think about the community, one of my name is one of the folks that pop up. I won't say I'm the smartest. I always walk in the room like I'm the dumbest person in there, but a lot of people don't see it that way. They seek my advice. It's going to be really missed. I miss the people. I miss the knowledge that I gained just by having these different calls and community events. So yeah, I will miss that. As I said before, the community is always everything, and that's always going to be the hardest thing to get rid of, or to lose once you retire, I guess. So with that, I didn't have anything else on my schedule, so I was working and building these little checklists. I've always tried to use like little index cards, and I'll like, all right, these are, every day I have a card, and these are my to-do list, these are my schedule things, they're important things. When I'm done, I can just toss it or whatever. I always try to do that as much as possible. So yeah, I got some stuff about de-winterizing an RV, some housework that I want to do this weekend, and I'm just kind of adding and building onto it. I figure I'd carry it around with me and just add as I'm thinking about things. So I want to build a couple of platforms out in the yard to train my little puppies, my little terriers. We were out there eating grass and rolling around. So yeah, I think it's going to be an interesting weekend. It's going to be a long weekend. And then when I go back to work Tuesday, I will have just what, 3 days, I believe. And I plan on taking next Friday off as much as possible too. So, but we'll see what happens in between that, since most of the week is just going to be checking out and out processing. No more customer work. But anyways, I figured I would talk a little bit about AI. There's a lot of hype, a lot of initiatives with AI. And even my company is pretty big into it. And I even have interest in learning a little bit if it can help me with, investing my money in the market or whatever. If it could help me with my retirement fund, it can do, whatever. I don't know where it's at. I don't know how to make it, but it's something that really, really interests me. So if it can help me make money and secure my future, why not take advantage of it? So I was reading an article when I was doing some searching about it. And I came across, they said like 9 out of 10 investment managers are using AI now. So they said 50% of investment managers are using some form of it. And there's another 37% that are planning to use AI here. So I thought that was kind of interesting. 9 in 10 investors or investment managers are using AI. So I think AI is huge. And It's something, if you have funds, why not invest into it, right? If you believe in it. I have some investments in the AI area. I believe it's going to become a big thing. No way around it. So they were talking about in this article that AI can pass the bar exam, or what do they call that? The uniform bar exam. Apparently that's a real hard exam. I don't know. I've never tried. I've never even studied for it. But they say that it can pass that exam far better than students can right now. And that it does very well as a certified public accountant or CPA. So yeah, AI is making strides, but where it struggles apparently, certified financial planner, CFP, there hasn't been any AI in that area that has successfully passed that exam yet. So that kind of that kind of tips your hat off for people that do pass that. That must be a really hard exam. Not anything I've ever checked into, but give us some time. It's going to pull some strides. But where they did say that AI was, providing good information and valid, I guess with all the different AI systems out there, they said that all the models had the same, they emphasized on the same stuff. Minimize your debt. Start investing early, as early as you can. If you haven't started investing, you need to invest. You need to get your money to work for you. One thing I did learn was no lazy dollars. Make your money work for you. If it's just sitting in the bank, it ain't doing much for you. You need to do something with it. So put it in a money market. Put it in something. Make a little bit more money than what regular old bank account's going to do. For me, I've been investing my money in about 20 years or more. That's where most of my money is funding my retirement, I guess. But, I kind of just set it and forget it and forgot about it for 20 years, just about. Looked at it during COVID, and then manipulating and playing it lately, and I'm still learning. There's so much to learn about it, but don't be afraid to try to get your money working for you. They were saying that the other things that these models gave similar answers were use tax advantage retirement accounts like 401ks and IRAs. So that's where the models did really, really well. And pretty much gave this straight answer. So it made it kind of makes you wonder, like, well, what was the ones that weren't very good? I don't know. The article didn't really go into, hey, what it wasn't good at, but at least you have a good information to kind of start if you haven't. IRAs, 401ks, you have to invest. And a lot of people just don't. A lot of people in the company are like, "Oh, Amy, wish I was you." And a lot of people, don't want to. I guess as soon as they got money, they spend it. I don't know what they do with it. We don't really think about that because we're not taught to save our money, to invest our money as kids or even as adults. You're always measured by the toys you have, the success. The white picket fence, the biggest house, nicest car and clothes and stuff. And that's success right there. But we don't need to be successful with all that glitz and glamour. I guess most millionaires, you wouldn't know they're millionaires because they live frugal and below their means. So if you're living below your means, I guess that's a good place to be. So, interesting. Just some food for thoughts. I thought that was an interesting article. T-7. And we'll go from there. Next Friday will be my last day, and then I will go into retirement. Number one question I'm getting lately is, what are you going to do your first day into retirement? I don't know. No clue. I have absolutely no clue. It's going to be a Saturday. So it'll probably just feel like any other Saturday. I think Monday, when everybody goes back to work, I think that's probably when it's going to hit the most. But we'll find out. And we'll see. So tomorrow we'll try to do another one. If not, then I'll try to do one Monday. All right. Yeah. You guys take care. Thank you for watching. And then see you on the next one.